Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Spongebob Squarepants, about for King Bonham for the GBA. Apparently the neighborhood's going somewhere today. Let's find out where. Last episode was rather fun as well. Being mainly comprised. Oh, you know what I can do? Oh, darn it. I can do that. Ah! Anyways, hi, Sandy Street Dome. Last level was comprised of finding it. Oh, I guess it doesn't have spikes on its head, so that would be reasonably, but I can still bounce on it. Okay. Is that a bullet? That totally is. Is this game trying to be Mario World? Bubble versus bullet. Bubble win. Yeah, bubble wins. Ha! But anyways, that's what I was saying. Last episode, we discovered that. In fact, do I literally only have to. Like, can I bounce off the bullets? Like, how Mario World are we gonna try to get here? I have a feeling that it's just gonna be too Mario World. Okay, I got shot. Anyways, for like the fourth time, I'm gonna try to say it. Oh, well, damage boosting works too. Wow. So, one more try. Last episode, we found out that there are, in fact, more minigames to be seen if I actually manage to complete them successfully. But it looks like all the minigames are pretty much just exact copies of. Well, not copies, but the exact same thing as the. Whoa, no, thank you. Can I eat those? Yep. Wait, can I like shoot them back out at. That's interesting. Pretty much the exact same thing as the boarding stages in the two-dimensional canola games, which I never liked. You have to collect stuff all the same. Same way I hate collecting dream stones in those. Hi. Oh, you want me to actually eat him and bring him over here to. There's a problem with that idea, child. Okay, there we go. I guess Mystery doesn't eventually swallow things like Yoshi does. Anyways, so it's not the type of stage I enjoyed anyway, so unless there's. Oh no! A promise of it changing in a way that makes you enjoy it more. I'm not going to be especially inclined to try to beat those special stages and see more of them and win all the photos. But just for the sake of it, I'll still try to pick up all the cryo patties. Why do I have keys? It's quite the door. Put in a real effort. That's weird. What's happening here? So if I just hold up and press the jump button, Mystery acts like she's trying to fly. I don't know why. Instead of actually jumping. What is that? Why? Oh, that sound. I admit, I didn't like most of the sounds in Revenge of the Flying Dutchman for GBA. Man, we didn't need keys to reappear in this game. Keys did not make Revenge of the Flying Dutchman better. They're not gonna make this game better either. Oh, come on. It was never vital to the enjoyment of the game for anybody, I assure you. Okay. It looked pretty. I give you that. That's one of the coolest ways I've ever seen to open a door. Okay. Better than I thought it would. Stop that. Alright. Let's try to get this go better this time. Aha. Up we go. Did not need to go up. I got shot for that. Aha! Dodging a bolt like something on the Matrix. It was weird holding something in some way without having my movement impeded in any way, shape, or form. Huh, Mystery can also move things. Can I, like, leave Mystery with stuff in her mouth? I can. Okay. Wait, does Mystery push things faster than I do? Oh, Mystery is the only one that can push that, actually. Okay. I'll take it. Go away. I can live with that, then. Something that Mystery can accomplish that I cannot. Other than just floating for a slightly longer distance. That was not much of a jump, SpongeBob. Okay. Now, why would I want to push that? I'm not sure why I want to deal with this. No, I guess that helps me get up there, maybe? Can I not already get up there? I could. Okay. Sure. I'll go with it. At the end of the stage now. One last jump. Okay, we're good. Make sure there are no bottomless pits that will present an issue for me. Alright. Bonus! Except we've seen it before. I haven't really done well with it in any case until now. Oh man! I was actually doing too well up until right then. Man, I'm pretty sure I'm just a bounce off that enemy, actually. What am I? I'm not sure. This also could be going a lot better. Better than that, too. I got a little bit further than I thought I would. It's a really good glide this thing has. That was ineffective. Also, I just tried to drop down that hole. It did not work. Safety features on the visible bolt mobile are very effective, evidently. Come on, I was trying to bounce off the thing. I apologize, it's a little difficult to tell where you're gonna land when you're landing with something invisible. Also, it seems to be some drop drive. Alright, well, that was effective. Can I jump off the R1? I'd like to do that. Now would be an effective time to use that tactic. Okay. Things are actually going pretty well. That go high. Aw, come on, almost! That's the only go high I intended for it too, but it almost worked out. I'm checking out for more things I don't want to jump over. Going to plan. Well, SpongeBob's happy, and that's all that matters. Nuts and bolts. Oh, hi. I have a timer. Oh, okay. Plus, that's my wetness timer. Okay. I can survive a minute without wet. Alright. So that's the idea. Wait, but these rods can't be destroyed anyways. What's the idea? So I'll start to look funny on the top right if I... Or top right on the top of the screen if I just let him stay dry for a while. I would like to see him dry out. Dry SpongeBob looked amazing in Battle for Keybon for the GBA. I'm sure console. We all know that. I guess I was going to become his patch ones. But his sprite doesn't change. That's the sad part. I wanna see him though. I wanna see the picture on top. You're gonna need that extra life, SpongeBob. Does he at least have an interesting animation for it or something? Nope. Just disintegrates. And I'll feel all that similar again. That was fun, though. I think that was well worth it. Okay. Well, we don't need that. Alright, let's go. We can actually have more than 9 lives in this game. I just realized. That was not the case in Malfi Mono, or not. Ninja Flying Dutchman. There's nothing in here. There's nothing of note. There's nothing of interest. Why am I here? Why can't I just like that? Something I never really understood in this game or Malfi Mono for console was why you couldn't just wear something on your head. Why can't you just wear a fishbowl on your head, Spongebob? The solution has always worked for you in the past. This game's not hurt me at all. Seems like they don't. I fear they existed for more than just locomotion. I fear they'd actually hurt me too if I touched them the wrong way. Apparently not. It's interesting. Enemies aren't really... Enemies straight up don't hurt you and they'll attack you in any way. Are they really enemies at that point? I'm getting all philosophical about it. So we can get that life again. Cool. And, just for style. Ah, I want to play on the bird bath. Soak it all up. Like a mop. Come back! Stupid robots that are out of sync. So it seems like this is just a big platforming challenge. Bird bath. Okay. I guess there's another area off to the right then. So you only have one spatula so far. But almost half the patties. What is this? That is a table, I suppose. Why are there multiple trees? Not true to SpongeBob canon. Also, hi. Hello. Robots are... Why is the favorite thing... The favorite activity of all these robots is just floating. Up and down. Why is this? It's a very different breed of robots from what we found in... in the console version. Very sadistic, and sometimes very creative, and capable of putting on good puppet shows. Right, that we saw in Rocky Bottom for the... Ah, come on. Consoles. Got a hidden patty in there. So much to do inside. Hopefully not. Well, yes, there is. I can live with waiting for a moment here. Soak. Alright, now I can head on up. And see what life has to offer. Maybe not. Oh. Okay, so I was thinking that those turn her mystery if you touch them directly. Apparently they don't even hurt SpongeBob if you touch them directly. These robots don't do anything. Like, they're not... They're not hostile. They're just in places. They don't hurt anybody or anything in any way, except for one that's covered in spikes, and that's only if you touch the spikes yourself. I have a hard time. Oh, well, I'm here now. Oh no! Man. That happened. How'd I end up in another... Guys, explain this to me. How's it at the top of one tree? Oh, I guess this. I'm going around the same tree and it's the other side of the tree. Okay. Now this makes sense to me. There's a reason behind this. Okay. I just need to think a little bit. Yeah, though, seriously, like, how are these robots taking over anything? They're not hurting anybody in any way or anything like that. Don't use violent means like the ones in Donald's version did. Oh, I'll send you that. Oh, come on! I have so much water, man. Why'd I get so much... There we go. I'll make them mind with that. So the reason you glide right after attacking an enemy, you get so much horizontal momentum. Dude. I better have water up here. Oh no! This poor Bob! That's inconvenient. Okay, cool, I get all my stuff back. Please. Okay. Didn't lose anything out from the oven, just a single life. There you go. So all is well. So I know what to do to get out of this place at least. So we'll be able to worry about that later. And now we have everything done. Okay, cool. Soak up a little bit, and we can head on out and be done with this place. And what time have we gone so far? We are ready, actually, to end this episode, so we can do that pretty soon, too. Let's get on out first. Come on. So, now I can head on up again. Apparently not. I'm waiting for all these robots to align perfectly. Come on. Here we go. Ah, oh, man, it was so perfect. Oh, no. That's not supposed to happen. Now I have to kill that robot, I think. Come on. Run, robot. There you go. At least there's a system in place that lets you fix that if something like that happens. Ah! Platforming is just almost as frustrating as it was in Revenge of the Flying Dutchman. Okay. Alright, so we know what to do. Now push this guy. Why? Okay, one more go. Push this guy. So you need to be really careful about gliding after. Come on. Okay, we're good. And now if I die, I'll just respawn in the same room. You need to be really careful about gliding after. Do it! Ha ha! Getting something though, after. What do you need to be careful about gliding after? After bouncing off an enemy, because you often have way more momentum than you need as a result. Aha! I already missed one, but. Except for that easy one that I accidentally missed. All things fair. That one always gets me. Whatever. No. I did say One Wheel Madness, but that's not. That was in the Invisible Boatmobile. Whatever. So I'll see you guys next episode of Let's Say Some Scrimmage about Bikini Bottom when we have an attack of a steel squirrel, apparently. We'll see where. I don't know if it's going to be the same place as last time in the console version. We'll see. See you guys.